Hey guys, it's Holly here from PlayStation Access. Now, despite my insane lack of rhythm and any musical talent, because we all know that Jackson got it all, I am here with Dan today talking about Rock Band 4. We're in a really cool bar setting. They've let me behind the bar, but I'm not allowed the tequila. But talk to us today about Rock Band 4. Now, you are finally coming out on this generation, so PlayStation 4 for the first time. Talk about self-expression. Oh, you said this was big.
So here's the thing, you know, it's like we took a hard look at Rock Band. You know, the first thing that we did when we really leaned into our development process was go back and play the games. And, you know, a few things really stood out. One is that these games are really fun. You know, Rock Band 3 is a great game. I'm very proud of it. At the same time, in terms of the fantasy of what it is to play music on stage with your friends, you know, in front of a crowd under the lights, there were things that were missing. And, you know, one of the things that, you know, is sort of at the top of that list is that when you're playing music, you're doing it all. And when you stop doing it, it stops. And in fact, in that sort of, you know, expression is a tremendous amount of power. And you can do what you want. And good musicians, you know, even if they're playing songs that other people have written or whatever, they find ways to turn these songs into their own songs and to own them, really. And so that turned into a design challenge for us. You know, what could we do across, you know, guitar, vocals, bass, drums to allow people to get that sense of ownership? You know, whether, you know, and it has to be done in keeping with some of the fundamentals of the platform, you know, accessibility being paramount. We don't want you to have to go to music school to play Rock Band. It's
Thank
the
God.
Opposite,
because
right?
It's probably not gonna happen for me.
And well, you and everyone else. So the idea is really like, you know, what can we do to give you that fantasy fulfillment of playing your parts in the context of some of the greatest music in rock and roll history. And we have a lot of very interesting ideas. You know, what we've shown today is, you know, focusing in on the singer.
Yes.
And sort of allowing a singer who likes to sing and is good at singing to really go off script and sing what they want and yet get points for it, to be scored and to kind of, you know, the game is really designed to draw that singer out of their shell and showcase charisma and expression and all of the things that, you know, make singers sing. That's why they do it in the first place.
So besides from freestyle vocals now, drumming as well. You guys have worked on some of the drumming, so drum fills. Do you want to talk a bit about getting creative with drumming?
Sure. So one of the big issues with drums historically has to do with system latency, actually. Yeah. And it's not super sexy, but it's really important.
Drumming, it is important. Everyone forgets how important latency is. You
drumming is all about time.
Yeah.
It's all about timing. And anything that is happening in the game that messes with your time is a really big deal, and a lot of people have systems that are running through, you know, a home theater system or a stereo system or whatever that, you know, adds in maybe 30 or 40 milliseconds of latency.
That's a lot.
And that's the difference between being in or out. And so when we flip from playing, you know, the song to playing your own fill to going back to the song, that can be a really hard transition. So we developed a system that, you know, we it's designed to keep some of the variety in the song, but still keep you in time all the time. And that's where the dynamic drum fills comes in. And you know, the way it works is we're sort of pulling from a very deep pool of fills that we then slot in based on the genre, the difficulty, at certain key moments over the course of the song. So it's always different, but it's also always in time, and that's a big win.
I think one of the biggest things about Rock Band is, of course, playing together. You've got all your friends there in the living room. What are you guys doing to help with building playlists and sets? Because obviously one of the biggest arguments you're ever going to have is what you play next.
Right. And in fact, that was the thing that, again, when we looked back at some of the earlier games in the franchise, we noticed that people would spend a tremendous amount of time arguing about what to play next. And while that's fun, there are some great dynamics in that conversation. Really, the game is more fun than the conversation. And so we developed a system that allows people to kind of pick from a set of multiple choice options at the end of a song and then vote on what you play next. And so it's really, it's timed. You only have about 10 seconds to make
a
choice.
No dithering, like, come on.
And you're not necessarily picking songs that you know, which is actually one of the sort of backdoor benefits to this feature where, you know, one of the things that happens when you go back to your song list is you sort of tend to pick songs that you know really well, that you've played before,
Guilty
that you're
that.
Really good at. And yet Rock Band is such a great vehicle for music discovery, and there's something so awesome about exploring your library and getting into the nooks and crannies, the songs that you maybe haven't played in a little while, particularly if you have a lot of DLC, and tying that into your experience. And this system does that really elegantly, and then it also still creates a lot of those really fun personal dynamics where, you know, the drummer and the bass player are teaming up against the vocalist and like, come on, you know, it's like those kinds of dynamics are really fun.
What about the audience response? How is that going to work as well with encores and things like that?
Well, so we've put a lot of effort into our crowd system, you know, where we really want the singer specifically, but really the band, to develop a relationship with the audience. And that is another area of the fantasy that is actually really powerful. If you've ever been on stage and, you know, said, hey, we are here to rock, and have that like audience just sort of explode on you, you know, it's like, that's
maybe
actually really,
day.
No, but it feels so great. It's like it's a moment that you remember for the rest of your life. And, you know, those are the kinds of moments that we really wanted to build into Rock Band. And so, you know, we have a crowd that, you know, can give you a little bit of sass at times, but really, you know, our mantra is to, you know, is to revel in the elements of the fantasy that are accessible and make you feel awesome. You know, that's sort of at the top of our list, is when you're playing Rock Band, you should just feel awesome all the time, and the crowd helps you get there, you know, and they are supportive of you, and they, you know, they laugh at your jokes, and they sort of, you know, will request songs, and, you know, it allows us to play around with it. There are some elements for, or some opportunities, I would say, for humor in terms of how we sort of develop the script and sort of the attitude, the personality of the crowd, but really they're there to, you know, to be the other part of that relationship, which is a big deal.
Now, previously you touched on DLC. Now, we just want to confirm that if you have PS3 to PS4,
yep,
DLC, everything you have will come along with you, and your old peripherals will work as well?
Absolutely, and, you know, this ties into a philosophy, really, that we've had going all the way back to, you know, Rock Band 2, where, you know, you could pull your Rock Band 1 DLC forward, and, you know, and you know, for us, it's about a respect for the customer and making sure that we value the investment that they've made. You know, it's like a lot of people have spent a lot of money on their controllers or on,
yep,
their library, and we want to do everything that we can to respect that. And, you know, we've got a great relationship with Sony. They've bent over backwards to support this as well.
Well,
and, you know, it's they understand that value as well. And, you know, it's been wonderful working with them.
Final thing, set lists, right? Because these games live and die by their set list.
Yeah.
Are you guys still taking requests?
Absolutely.
How does the community, if they can, get involved and put some suggestions
actually,
together?
Actually, so if you go to the Harmonix website, harmonixmusic.com, we actually have a voting panel where, you know, and we built this like straight out of our announcement, because we started getting email after email. And so you can just put in a song, and there are a few rules. You can only put in one song once. You know, it's like we're trying to prevent people from, you know, throwing in thousands of requests for the,
yeah,
same song. But like, what we've seen is that we've had over a million songs,
oh my god,
requested,
wow,
since March. It's insane.
That's,
right,
when your licensing team had just sat there like this, like,
no,
what,
but,
are we gonna,
but,
do?
But it's a great story, you know. It's like, you know, a song like the Avenged Sevenfold song that we have is, you know, at the top of that list.
Wow.
And so we're able to really look at that, and it ties into a long-term goal that we have for Rock Band 4, which is to really engage in a dialogue with our customer base, right?
Yep.
And have them tell us what they want. What do they want to play? What do they want to hear?
Yep.
What features do they want? What do they not like about the game? And for us to really have a very sophisticated conversation,
yep,
about how Rock Band 4 can evolve over time, not just through content, but through features as well, and then deliver that, you know? And we're in a position to be very responsive, which is fun. It's sort of, you know, the best of both worlds. You know, it means, I mean, obviously we have a lot of opinions and ideas, but we're not just sort of, you know, looking at a marketing agency,
yep,
to tell us what people want. We can just talk directly to the people, and I love that.
Amazing. Well, thank you so much for your time. Stay tuned to our YouTube channel. We've got more coming up.